visualization. How to see things? How to see things means we are seeing things, but visualization is something which is entirely different. It has five steps. Seeing things as they are now before our eye. It is known as optical vision. Then we are having micro-optical vision, macro-optical vision, para-optical vision, tele-optical vision, onto-optical vision, abyss-optical vision. By these things, we have to create new things which may give the feeling that it is being seen but not being seen by you. If you think the things which are not seen, you can produce the thing with things which are not seen but which could be seen. That is known as creative designing or drawing. So it is known as paroksha darshana, aproksha darshana, we used to say in Sanskrit. So you see something, I am seeing this, and this is an object, and seeing something behind it, seeing something beyond it, having a structural change, functional change, alternative assembly, all of these things are very extended exercises of the same vision. That is known as visualization. Vision is different from, that's what I told, vision to envision and to have this type of vision. These three things are entirely different from each other. Visualization is to see something which is not there by your creative imagination. Envisioning is seeing something which exists now. And to have a vision is to see something which is beyond our sight. So to add something to the existing vision is known as creative intelligence. To exactly see something is known as envision. And to see something in future and to make the same thing happen, it is a type of a spiritual vigor. We used to call it as a vision. The person is known as visionary. So this type of visualization is in between normal vision and envision. So envisioning is made by all of us. We are seeing innumerable things. And visionaries are special personalities. They may be national personalities or spiritual personalities. Those who are having a broader area, those who are having a deeper thought, those who are doing for a mega transformation, they are known as visionaries. And envisioning people are normal people. So this creative intelligence comes between these two areas. And in visualization, you have different visualizations. Now in the same multimedia skills also, different softwares are produced, different analytical languages, scripts and codes are made in various other forms and disciplines of life. Number one is scientific visualization. Now they are having medical imaging. Medical visualization is there. Chemical visualization of covalent bond structures and their mixture, fusion, everything is made. In nano engineering also, bio-nano compatibility of these antibodies, protein elements, everything is visualized. So this is visualization, technical visualization and internal visualization that is being done. Astrophysical visualization is being done for planetary motions, comets, equinoxes, apogees, everything is measured by that. This thing is known as scientific visualization. Second thing is known as education visualization. We are using tools for teaching people by the same visualization method. How to teach others? You see, scientific visualization is for self-understanding and boosting others. For those who are semi-sufficient, those who are imbecile, for upgrading them, education tools are used. Third is information visualization using technology-aided tools. Now that is developing. The fourth thing is we are having knowledge visualization now. Like prognostic softwares are there. Prognostic, experimental, experiential, prospective, predictive, perceptual. All of these various types of views of knowledge. What do I think? That is my conceptive information. What do I see? That is my perceptive information. What would have been there? It is a predictive or calculative or futuristic imagination. What I have culled out of my observations and subjections, that is my experiential, experimental. All of these things are knowledge transactions. They are coming under knowledge visualization. These are all the various groups of visualization now. Why I am saying this thing is, multimedia is having an evergreen market in the society. Even though the IT industry, it may die or it may just go down and come back, it may have an internal shaping, it may become purely domestic instead of being international or anti-national, it may take a national or intranational or inter-domestic drive and development, things may change. But in this development era, with the technology, visualization, designing, modeling, simulation, these things are having evergreen market because they does the work of 10 people and they create the impact of 100 organizational output. So that type of technical support widely and provincially is suffered by lot of people, lack of proper technical resources, because human intelligence has been totally eroded. there are no proper people available now. Proper team is also not available. If a single person itself is very scarce and unavailable, how to talk about a team? So the only dandagrahana, walking stick for this tottering innate technology is the development of scientific technology. So this thing is having lot of possibilities and prospective developments, so that everybody entering inside with proper direction would have a perennial support of this technology, and he can contribute much in advancement and upgradation of the technology. Even in conceptive development, I think that most of the people are here connected only with creative designing in entertainment mode, in creating something in scientific modeling and everything, etc. Most of the people are about to do something in advertisement, telefilms, documentaries and other things, etc. So conceptive designing is a very great headache, and it is it can be done only by few people. This type of pictorial, depictive, multilateral, attractive designing anybody can do, but conceptive designing is very boresome. It requires a lot of splendid skills like that. So it is known as, for example, if you take a concept, there will be evolution of concept, there will be comparison of concept, there will be deployment of concept. So if you take a concept, it will have a lot of components. For example, if I say my grandfather, father, myself, my son, if I take these elements, certainly it is an evolution, it is a hierarchy. If something creates other things and creates a creation tree, that is known as a tree model. Now they are having the tree model. Multiversity is also having a tree symbol, emblem for it. Like that, there is a tree model for that. There is a chart model. Chart model means there are innumerable charts, like pie chart is there. Pie chart model, it is very famous. Fine chart model is there. Table chart model is there. Cripple chart model is there. Hub chart model is there. Block chart model is there. Chart models are also innumerable. And they are having arginogram. They are having Wann and Euler's diagram is there. We are having even molecular graphics, how to make the graphics for molecules. Molecular graphics is there, technical drawing is there, illustrative drawing is there, cacophonic drawing is there, innumerable things are there within that. So now what we want to know is, somebody should take in this designing to do with concepts, somebody to do with presentations, somebody to do with achievements. Presentations things are known as light and entertainment oriented. Achievement or accomplishment area is known as scientific analysis, pursuit and execution. These basic conceptive things are there in planning, systematization and cognitive drill. There are three areas in the same thing. One is conceptive, second thing is illustrative or presentation. The third thing is very much confined with other developments like science and other things, modeling and everything, etc. And depending upon the taste of the people, I have already told about the cognitive taste, but somebody may be interested in the conceptive development, somebody in the cognitive development in scientific modeling, somebody in the entertainment. But the entertainment mode is more appealing, it has more scopes, it has mass attraction, it has a money minting inbuilt industry by which everybody is interested in going inside. It is a common thing like that. And now there are innumerable institutes of research, but I want to say about something. There is Chitra Kala Sara, created by Mrityunjaya Shastri. Mrityunjaya Pandita, he has made Chitrakala Sara, and whatever he has made before 9th centuries, they are very much, they are compatible as well as very much comparable, identifiable as well as explorable even in the presence of modern technology, tools and concepts available. So somebody should take some initiatives to print that with a comparative study of modern education of creative technology and its tools. There are innumerable schools of that, like there is a Collins College of Graphics, there is McIntosh College and Institute of Graphics, Creative Designing is there in Madsen Creative Designing Institute. There is an international institute for research in designing,